Breaking news now. John Roberts reporting to us from the White House that a source tells John that the gag order on the FBI informant regarding the Clinton collusion could be lifted as early as tomorrow. John Roberts also telling us that there is a desire at the Justice Department to get Senator Grassley, the chairman of the Senate Judiciary Committee, all of the information on this corruption case that he has asked for and will require. The same source telling our John Roberts that Rod Rosenstein, the deputy attorney general, may not be as exposed as some are reporting or would have you believe. He did have a role in part of that case, but apparently was not in a position to know all about it, nor all about the gag order that had been put into effect against the informant. Well, joining us tonight, Circa News investigative reporter Sara Carter, who's been reporting on this case and broader corruption in the swamp for some time now. And Sara, great to have you with us.
Oh, thank you, Lou. It's good to be here.
And again, congratulations on your terrific reporting. John Roberts saying now the gag order, as Victoria Tansing, the informant's attorney, said here last night, all she wanted was for that gag order to be lifted, the informant ready to tell Congress and anyone who will listen what he knows about what has been 5 years of corruption in which the Clintons are implicated, allegedly.
Yes, allegedly. And I can tell you this, I was talking to Victoria Tansing earlier today. Mm-hmm. I've also had the opportunity to meet through his attorney, the informant, myself. He is he bound by a non-disclosure agreement, which he desperately wants lifted so he can talk about his time that he spent as a confidential informant for the FBI for 4 years, during which time the FBI was investigating both the Russian nuclear arm and people associated with it that were committing briberies, kickbacks, money laundering, international money laundering, and affecting businesses here in the U.S., as well as their attempt by Vladimir Putin to expand his uranium global reach. So this is huge news, Lou. This is incredible news, because at this point in time, there's never been an actual eyewitness into the Uranium One deal. And also developing today, Lou, as you know, was the announcement made by both the House Intelligence Committee and Oversight Committee, who is backed behind, you know, right behind Senator Grassley and the Judiciary Committee, are now conducting their own investigation into this.
Yeah, and credit to them, credit to Congressman Ron DeSantis, who has been pushing hard here, Congressman Jim Jordan as well. But at the same time, it is not movement on the part of the Justice Department, led by Attorney General Jeff Sessions. And as you well know, without the grand juries, without the Justice Department engagement on this case, I find it hard to see how we can see, we may learn far more, and I expect we will, but we can't really bring to justice the Russians, the conspirators in this country, and the dirty cops and dirty politicians, all of whom were engaged in conspiring against the U.S. national interest.
Well, right now, according to sources that I've spoken with, you know, Attorney General Jeff Sessions is very much involved in this right now. I don't want to make any assumptions that he's not going to follow through. I want to sit back and wait, see what happens tomorrow, what develops tomorrow as far as lifting that non-disclosure agreement. Remember, the Justice Department also has to work with the FBI, because this criminal case that we've exposed was also started out as a counterintelligence operation. Now, that's considered highly classified, so
Say, let me interrupt you there, Sara, because no longer do I believe that many of the people in Washington who represent us, that is Congress and the Senate, are buying the bull that it's a counterintelligence operation on the part of an also law enforcement agency, namely the FBI, within the Justice Department, in which the usual result is to shroud the truth, shroud those who are guilty, whether it's Benghazi, whether it's Fast and Furious, the IRS case, whatever it may be. The FBI ends up being a cloak rather than a ray of sunshine and bright light on corruption.
I couldn't agree with you more on a lot of the points you just made, Lou. But I can tell you this, that Victoria Tonsig, when I spoke with her earlier today, she is insistent that the full NDA be lifted, that he be able to speak freely.
She told us the same thing last night.
Yeah, so I think this is going to be a push, not a partial lift, but a complete lift, so he can tell everyone his story, and particularly lawmakers who are asking these questions and who are now conducting the first major investigation into Uranium One.
I just want the Justice Department to change what has been their culture for so long, and that is to get out of the shroud business and get into the searchlight business, if you will. It's time for the American, this is the United States of America, folks. This is not the Soviet Union, and we're being treated by this government over the past, particularly 8 years, being treated as if it were a Soviet government rather than an American one. We've got to change this, including the JFK files that come up on the 26th, the president announcing he's going to open those up. Think about this, Sara, 54 years later.
It's incredible. It's incredible. I know there are so many reporters and so many Americans and people all over the world that are finally going to get a chance to see what happened with John F. Kennedy, too. So this is an incredible time. And I think, you know, it's one step at a time, one layer of the onion, one peel back each revealing something new.
Rip it to pieces. I am so sick of this crap. I can't stand it. And I think Americans are, it's just time to quit treating us like mushrooms. And you know exactly what I mean when I say that.